YouTube. I'm back again today for another game review, and today I'm very excited to check it out. Mint Tin Pirates from Subquark. This is for two players, ages 10 plus. It'll take about 5 to 15 minutes to play. Also, disregard that ages 10 plus. You can probably easily play this with a 7 or an 8-year-old, just a heads up. This is a micro two-player game in which you are going to be the captain of a pirate ship, and you're going to be either trying to kill all of your other opponent's pirates or potentially sink their ship by hitting it 4 times with a cannon. Along the way, there's ghosts and golds and throwing knives and bombs, all sorts of cool stuff like that. It's a micro game, but does it pack a lot of fun? I don't think that's an expression. Let's open it up and I'll tell you.
Alrighty then, we're going to take a look at what you're going to get inside of Mint Tin Pirates. First and foremost, we got our handy dandy rule cards. They're very well done. They will have you up and running in no time at all. It's a very simple game, so I can teach you how to play right now. So in Mint Tin Pirates, it's a two-player micro game in which one player is going to be taking control of the red pirate ship, one player is going to be taking control of the black pirate ship, and you are going to be trying to either kill all of your opponent's pirates or sink their boat by hitting it 4 times with a cannon. You're going to do that by playing these cards down right here, and you're going to be trying to play them into sets of 2. And we'll go over one of these cards and show you how it works. So for instance, this one means you're trying to shoot someone else on the other boat. So if you had 2 of these cards on your turn, you could play them down. And if you're able to successfully roll these 2 die and get a 6, a 7, or an 8, then one of your opponent's pirates would be dead and would fall into the water. Then you would discard these cards. Now you may also notice that there's some numbers and a symbol right there. This number is how many of this card is in the deck, and this symbol right here is how much of a chance you have to actually succeed at hitting the other pirate. So for instance, the cannon, much more likely to succeed, you have more exclamation points, but if you roll 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, or 10, you're going to succeed. So, but you might also notice that there's less cannons. There's only going to be 8 of them in the game. So those are the cards that you're going to have. You're going to start off the game with 5 of them. You're going to have your pirate ship here at full health with 3 people on your boat. And then you are going to also have gold in the center of the table, which we'll talk about a little bit later, and a pirate ghost down in Davy Jones' locker, which we'll also talk about later. So let's go over exactly how the game is played. So on your turn, you are going to discard up to 2 of your cards. And then you are going to play a set of cards if you can. So, you draw back up to full hand. So we would discard these 2 cards right here, draw back up to 5 cards. And we actually were lucky enough to get a doubloon. There are only 4 of these in the games, but this is a wild card for all intents and purposes. And then we'll play these 2 right here. So we are shooting a cannon at the other ship. We play these down into the discard pile. We roll the dice. We got ourselves a 6, which means we have successfully hit the other boat. So they go down 1 on the health track on their boat. There is no way to fix your boat either. So that is something that I did want to note. Then you draw back up to 5 cards like so, and that is the end of your turn. Likewise, let's see what our opponent's got going on. So he's got a lot of cannons. So he might discard these 2 right here, draw back up 2, and he's got a pretty good hand going here. So now's the time to show you some of these special cards that are in the game. And there are 2 of them. These are the 2 you're going to potentially see. So this one is, if you have 2 of these, or if you have this and a doubloon, you can bring 1 pirate back to life and put him back onto your boat. Just not the ghost one, though. But you can potentially steal somebody else's pirate. So let's just say a black pirate's in the water. You play 2 of these and you're red. You roll successfully. He's now on your boat, which means you have a better chance of winning. This one also means that someone deserts from the other boat and comes to your boat. So essentially, that's a big switch because you could just go bloop like that, and that other person is in a world of hurt. So you're going to continue doing this back and forth until one of 2 things. First and foremost, the easy win condition is that you have hit their ship 4 times. Once you hit their ship 4 times, it sinks and the other player wins the game. Very simple. Now, the other win condition you can do is that what can potentially happen is all of your pirates can die. But all is not lost just quite yet because you have a ghost on your ship. So now you have a ghost pirate, which means you still get to play, but for the rest of the game, you only have 3 cards in your hand, which can make things exceedingly difficult. But hey, you're saying there's a chance. Now, you may also notice that there's still the gold there, which I haven't really talked about. The gold is if you roll double. So let's just say that somebody rolls a 4. They might have failed on trying to hit with something, but they still now get the gold on their ship. And this means they now get to have one extra card in their hand. So they would get to have 6 cards in their hands, whereas now this guy would get to have 4 cards in his hand, which could be very valuable. So the gold will be going back and forth from ship to ship. So, last but not least, I forgot to mention this. If you ever kill the pirate ghost, then the game is over, and that is the secondary victory condition. But anywho, you're going to continue to do that until you've either sunk in your opponent's ship or you've killed all their crew and then killed their pirate ghost, at which point one player will be the winner of Mint Tin Pirates. And that, in a nutshell, is how the game is played.
Alrighty then, Mint Tin Pirates from Subquark. What are my final thoughts? Let's cover the pros, let's cover the cons. First, on the con side, the game is not going to be for everybody for a lot of different reasons. It's a 2-player game, very restricted player count. Also, it is a micro game, which means it's not the deepest of games. It's a very shallow game, if we're going with that term, because on your turn, you're just going to discard cards, and then play cards, and then roll dice, and hopefully you're going to succeed at either hitting their boat or hitting one of their pirates, and that's just about it, or reviving your crew. So it's a very simplistic game, which is going to be a turnoff to some people. Also, it is very luck-based, and I forgot to mention this in the last review I did for Mint Tin Aliens, but I want to mention it here. What cards you draw are going to have a giant impact on how you do. If you discard 2 cards and you get the same 2 cards, well, then that's unfortunate for you. If you consistently roll high or low numbers, then that's just unfortunate for you. If you can't get doubles, that's just too bad. So it's a very luck-driven game, which is going to be a turn-off to some people. Not personally me, because the game is over way too quick to even care, but still something that I want to mention. Also, you see the front of the box, you see the pirate ships, you see the back of the cards, and the artwork is really nice. You're like, oh man, great artwork. Then you look at the cards themselves, and you're like, it's okay. I mean, the doubloon looks like, it looks pretty bad. It looks like a cookie. Some of the artwork just looks like it could be better, but I honestly didn't really care. I don't think most people are going to care, but it's something that I did want to mention. Any other cons that I have with the game? You know, I wish there was just a little bit more. I know Mint Tin Apocalypse, which I'll review eventually, had an expansion. And I feel like this game would be great to have an expansion. I'd love to see maybe like 2 or 3, maybe 4 expansion cards in there that fixed your boat. Why not some extra wood plank cards so you could fix your boat? But then again, that might extend the game out just a little bit longer. But either way, I want an expansion because I love this game. I don't like this game. I love this game. And I immediately recommend this if you're in the market for a 2-player game. I'm just going to put that as a period. Done. I'm not quantifying that as a micro game. I'm not quantifying that as a luck-based game. I just legitimately love this game, and I can't wait to play it more. There's a couple reasons why I love this game. First and foremost, I love theme, and the theme actually comes across pretty well in this game. At least for me, it does. I really enjoyed it, you know, pretending like you're throwing knives and shooting guns. The mechanisms worked with the theme, and the dice rolling actually worked with the theme for me, because if you're throwing a knife across the water at another pirate ship, yes, you're going to have a lot less of a chance to hit a pirate than you would if you're shooting a cannon. So the dice rolling actually kind of worked for me in that turn. I also love the game because as small as the game is, and as simple as this game is, it has alternate victory conditions, and I love alternate victory conditions. That's one of my favorite aspects of games, just period, where it's like, all right, I could go for the cannon, or I could try and knock out all of his pirates, because then he only has the ghost pirate, and he's going to be crippled, so to speak. But I love the ghost pirate mechanism in the game. I love when a game just gives you that tiniest little chance to succeed. Like, you should be done. All your pirates are dead. You should be done. The game should be over. But no, they were like, we're going to give you just this slight glimpse of hope that maybe, just maybe, you could turn things around. And I love when games do that. Also, I like the gold going back and forth when you roll double. Some people aren't going to like the randomness of that, but I personally did. It made things more interesting, especially if you're the pirate ghost. You're like, yes, I got the gold now, so I can have 4 cards. And it's like, you're getting excited about something that's stupid. That tells me the game is working. So overall, Mint Tin Pirates, I love this game. I really do. I played it about 4 or 5 times now, and each time I've played it, I've been like, man, I really like this game. It is a very solid game. It is one that I highly, highly recommend if you're in the market for a 2-player light micro game, or just a 2-player game in general that you can take on the go. So that is Mint Tin Pirates from Subquark. this game, comparing it to the other Mint 10 games, this one and Mint 10 Apocalypse, I love both of those games. It really depends on what kind of mood I'm in as to which one I like better. Only more playing of the games, then I'll eventually be able to give you an answer. So that is Mint 10 Pirates from Subcork. Highly recommended. If you enjoyed this review, please be sure to click on the subscribe button down below in the comments below. Let me know if you were a pirate. What would be the first thing, PG, please, that you would do when you got back to land? So you've been out on sea. It's been like 6 months. You got a whole bunch of booty, you know, gold, and you're ready to go. What's the first thing you're going to do? For me personally, well, I guess it really depends. Are we talking about being a pirate nowadays or talking about being a pirate back then? I'm going to go with nowadays. So nowadays, I think I would love to go take a... I go to a Chinese buffet. Pretty lame answer, but I go to a Chinese buffet because I imagine you would be just about tired of whatever they were cooking on the ship. But what would you do? If you were a pirate, you just got back to land, let me know in the comments below. And as always, thanks for your time, YouTube.